The Tabletop Bellhop team is here to answer your gaming and game night questions. Tonight's question comes from longtime fan of the show, our favorite blind meeple, Red Meeple Ryan, who asks, what games really need a box insert or need a better box insert for quick setup?
Yeah, great question there, Ryan. Now, we haven't talked about box inserts in quite some time, actually way longer than I actually thought. That is if you discount our reviews, because in our reviews, we often talk about whatever box insert does come with each game and if it's good or bad or needs improvement. But as for like just discussing box inserts in general, I had to look back. It goes all the way back to episode 4 of the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast. That's a long time ago. The name of that episode is Insert Tab A, and you can find it on the blog and YouTube. And there we decide whether box inserts are worth it, if they're worth something spending your money on.
Yeah, and maybe instead of going to listen to a podcast that the guys recorded 6 years ago, you could go read the article on the website, Are Box Inserts for Board Games Worth It? Then you won't have to listen to the guys before they had managed to figure out their podcast legs.
Well, either way, the important part is that we decided that inserts are very much worth it if they get your games to the table more often. Mm-hmm. The goal of a good insert is to make you want to play a game more because it's easier to set up, easier to take down, and even the best ones also provide some kind of in-game enhancement, like trays for individual resources, organization for individual player areas, display stands, or more.
Yeah, despite the episode and pairing article being almost 6 years old, I think everything we talked about there still stands. Now, Deanna wasn't with us on the show then. She was here, still here behind the scenes, of course. Do you have anything you want to say about box inserts and why they can be a good thing?
I think you guys already nailed it, and that ideally they make setup and cleanup quicker. But the one other thing that I look for in an insert is, does it keep the components safe? Is everything going to be put away in a manner that protects the games and all the bits? Because if an insert isn't protecting the game pieces from getting ruined when the box is jostled around, then it isn't doing its job.
Fair.
Yeah, and that's one thing I think a lot of gamers don't necessarily think about, because so many gamers slide their box out from the shelf and put it onto the table and slide it back into the table or slide it back into the box and aren't transporting games vertically in a trunk. But there are enough gamers out there who do want to travel with their games that it is an important feature to be able to even just stand it up, because there are enough people who want to store them that way. And certain games, we know that's not how you want to do it.
Yeah, this is for all the people up there who are bonkers and like to store their games vertically. I can't do it. Even with a good box insert, they often end up quite a bit of a mess. So I am definitely a store horizontal, but then I go host a game night and I bring 5 bags full of stuff to wherever I'm hosting an event, and they tend to stand upwards and get jostled around in the car and bumped around while we're moving them. And that's not always pretty, even with a good insert. Now, before we get to games or anything else we want to add about box inserts, like, you can listen to the old episode, read the article. Like I said, the big thing is that fact that you want to get to the table.
As we all know, the best game is the one you actually get to the table. And a game that is a pain to take out, set up, and put away probably isn't getting played as often. So that's a problem.
All right. Well, as usual, this list is in no particular order.
All right, first one that came to mind when thinking about this, when reading Ryan's question, was Zaya, Legends of Adrift System. Now, this is a game that comes with a plastic tray, one of those vacuum foamed inserts, and it's plastic clear tray that's okay. I hold some of the stuff great, like the metal coins and some of the various ships are okay, but then the upgrade tiles and stuff, there's kind of storage for them, but they're not stored very well. Plus, the insert is just there to hold it. And once you start playing, it's not like you can pass the insert around or anything. So when I first started playing this game, I used it in combination with baggies. So I had the various yellow upgrades in one bag and the various orange upgrades in another, and so on. But then as I started getting some of the promo material and the expansion content and the boxed expansion, the insert became pretty much useless. So I tossed it out, and my giant long box was just a box filled with tons of different baggies. Eventually, I went and picked up a custom wooden insert for it that is great. And honestly, this is fantastic because one of the best parts of that is it has individual trays for each of the upgrades so that I can now pass them around to other players. So when you go, hey, can you pass me the yellow upgrades? I can just pass them the tray and then it's ready to go and ready to be put away at the end of the game night. And the same thing is now I have the ship sorted out better. So I can just be like, here's your ship, here's your card, here's your starting stuff. It's good to go. So my first game of tonight is Zaya Legends of Adrift System, which has hit the table more often since I got a box insert.
So the first thing that came to mind for me was Catan. The version that we picked up back in 1990-something was just a big empty box inside with everything floating around in there, which, I mean, that's pretty typical for older games, right? I think that says something about the way the hobby's developed, that now you will often, or it's not, open up a game and it has some sort of tray in there. And then I realized I have no idea what the inside of the current edition of Catan looks like. And I was looking online and looking at pictures of various editions, and it seems like it's gotten better. But based on the number of Reddit threads out there discussing how to put away Catan hexes, I'm guessing it could still use some help.
Yeah, my research did the same thing. As Catan kept coming up, but I'm not a Catan fan, and I haven't had the experience, so I left that one to the experts.
I would say with Catan 2, it also gets a lot worse once you have expansions. So I have the old version. I still call it Settlers. I have a hard time calling the game Catan because to me it was Settlers. Let's play Settlers or let's play Farm with a certain group of players. But what the problem is, like my Catan, my base game, has all the expansion stuff in it because I have all the sorted by player color. So despite only having the tiles to play base Catan, if I hand myself the orange players, I have all the cities and knights stuff in there and the boats from Seafarers of Catan. And every time I like bring the game out to one of our public play events and someone goes to play it, I have to tell them, no, keep that in the bag, keep that in the bag, keep that in the bag. And I'm like, I honestly, we don't play the game enough anymore, but I almost want an insert just to be able to separate that stuff out and be like, here's your cities and knights stuff, here's your Seafarer stuff, here's your traders and barbarians, here's everything else.
My first game of the night is the stuff of Legend. Now, I picked this mostly because I just recently edited our unboxing of this, and it was painful to watch as the lid came off, and one of the first things on top of the box, even before the rules, was three loose decks of cards in shrink wrap. And then as you got in, there was a plastic tray with a lid on it to protect three minis. And then little Ziploc baggies of like board game quality soft plastic minis. It was kind of horrifying to watch with only the three big, giant, beautiful minis that were well protected. And then the rest of the tray was just kind of, oh, we have some leftover space after we protected these three minis, so we'll put in a divot and people can throw things in there. But the cards didn't even really fit in there. And then when we went and played it the first time, we had to do a whole lot of organizing and sorting because, again, everything just kind of gets mashed together. A beautiful looking game, not a beautiful looking insert that comes with the Stuff of Legend.
So next up, I have Gloomhaven. And this is the only game I can think of where we went and bought the insert immediately before even diving into the game. I cannot even imagine playing Gloomhaven without an insert. There is so much stuff in that box. How the hell do you sort and store it without an insert?
Yeah, I agree. This was one, like, we made the decision together. We're like, no, we've got to buy an insert because I've heard it from enough people online and podcasters how much of a mess it is. And even the insert we got was terrible for sorting the tiles. It was great for the monsters, it was great for the cards, and it sorted the tokens really well and the various card decks. But then you just layered all the tiles on top, and we were constantly spending way too long in the start of a live stream trying to find, where's 2B? If you've seen 2B, it looks like a hex. Oh, no, not that one. It has to have the doors on the other side. I honestly don't see. It was bad with our insert, and I can't imagine playing that game without something. My next one is Lost Ruins of Arnak. Just opening this up, I wanted to insert the first time. Just the number of chits, the number of tokens, the fact you've got cards. Anytime you got cards, this is something any game that has cards should have somewhere to store the cards that keeps them away from the other components so they don't get damaged, because you don't want to mark up cards. And yes, I know I could sleeve. I hate sleeving. I'd rather not sleeve. Just give me a better way to keep the cards separate from everyone else that I don't have to. Arnak was pretty bad. Tons of little tiny tokens. Now, one of the things, one of my pro tips is if you have kids, buy air dry clay, and then you get these nice little plastic containers from the empty clay that are great for sorting these things. Arnak got a lot better once I put the various resources, the, you know, the arrowheads, the compasses into their own things, but still, you still got those cards are loose and they're in baggies. So it just kind of needs something. And then you start adding the expansions, and now you have extra player boards, you've got extra components, you've got even more cards, and you're just going to want one even more. Now, I will admit, at this point, we have not upgraded our copy of Arnak. We do not have a box insert for it. But every time I open it up, I'm like, man, we probably should do something about this.
And one thing that I see that's already been called out in the chat room, and I saw everywhere, is sleeving isn't always a solution, and sometimes makes things worse, as so many games have not taken sleeves into consideration or require a different pack of the box if you're using sleeves versus how you were it came originally. And there's, you know, yes, if you're sleeving it, follow, you know, tab 6B of the put away instructions type stuff. So sleeves are not always the solution you wish they were. Now, my next game is Quacks of Quedlinburg. Now, we love this game, and it got so much better when we got the enhanced bits, but that doesn't help you put anything away. That's the putting things out on the table and putting them away is not made any easier by getting the fancier non-cardboard bits. Now, while the flexibility of the game and all of its pieces and different ingredients is part of the strength of this game and why we love it, the lack of organization for all of that material is frustrating. And then as you add expansions, it only gets worse. Yep. Now, while this is a great game, and that can overcome a lot of the annoyance of the game, knowing you've got to budget so much extra time on top of your game time to set up and tear down, even if everyone helps, does keep this game off the table when time is a little tight.
I agree on this one. Well, Quacks is one that we haven't upgraded. The Geek Up bits from Board Game Geek, go there, buy them. Yes, they almost cost as much as the game, but honestly, if you play this game often, you're going to, it's worth it. I think it's totally worth it. They were a gift, I will admit. They're a good gift. I definitely like them. I really want more upgrades for this one, as well as inserts. Like, if you can give me an insert where it separates out the three different levels of ingredients and gives me a way to hold the recipe card, I would love to see that.
Well, that's it. They have those Etsy boxes, those little 3D printed Etsy boxes where the card sits on the back and the chits go inside. It's not an insert per se, but it's a in the box, come out onto the table. And I've wanted those for forever, but the shipping to Canada is stupid.
Yeah, they are nice though. I know exactly the ones Dee's talking about, and they are nice.
Now, what I have seen, though, is kind of the compromise where those are part of a box insert, where you can get the box insert and it includes something like those. And I've seen box inserts designed to hold the ones that are sold on BoardGameGeek. So you can kind of get the best of both worlds there. And then to Sean's point, something else that we were talking about, what we like in inserts. I like inserts that let me separate the expansion content from the core game. That is a huge bonus to me, especially hosting public play events. When I'm playing with my home group and we're playing the game that we played 100 times before, it's great. I'll just dump everything together. But when I bring it out to a public play event, there are many games that play better with just the base game, especially with new players. You don't want to throw people in the deep end and scare them away. So having an insert where I can pull out all that stuff, like give me a Quacks insert where I can pull out, especially the alchemist stuff. I tend to keep herb witches in when playing with new players because I really like them and they help mitigate some of the randomness. But alchemist, I only use that when I'm using experienced players. So I would love just that one tray where I take alchemist out of the way and then we go. All right, my next one is Caverna, the Cave Farmers. This was the first game I planoed. Back before box inserts were as popular as they are now, and there were companies dedicated to producing them and 3D prints online and everything, the solution many board gamers had come up with, and I think this started with the war game community, is Plano, the Plano tackle boxes used for holding, you know, screws and nuts and bolts and fishing lures. Board Game Geek has a geek list, and I don't know how well it's still maintained, but back in the day, it was fantastic, where it had a list of pretty much every game I could think of and what plano fit exactly to hold everything with plans for what to put where. Like, it was a great thing. So this is what I did for Caverna, and I think this was two different planos that were fairly large just for the square tiles, another plano for the longer tiles that were two width, and then a smaller like tackle box like one for the resources. Now, even with all of these things to organize everything, the top of the box stuck up a good half an inch, so it wasn't the best solution. And I remember my cop, I even had some stuff slid down the sides of the plano to hold them into place. Eventually, I did go for a nicer wooden insert that stores all the things even better. But now, if I ever pick up the Frantic Friends expansion, I'll be SOL, because my insert does not have room for that. And I'm sure there are some out there that make room for the expansion as well.
My next one is Zulkin. Now, there is zero insert in there. When you there's not even a trough to divide things. You open Zulkin, you just got a box. And there are tons of tokens, bits and bobs for this game. We've got it all in plastic baggies, and it mostly handles it. But a decent insert would definitely help this one get to the table more often.
And from what I saw online, it's actually a problem with the entire T series of games. Tale to Awaken would be another one. I personally would rather have an insert for that than Zulkin, though actually Zulkin hits the table more here. But maybe Tale to Awaken would if I had an insert for it. But just the number of different components in those various games, I totally agree.
All right, well, my next game comes from the community. This is a game that I haven't actually played myself, but this is Baron Park. Now, I was doing research on this topic to try and dig a little deeper and see what the community and people out there have problems with, and this one kept coming up over and over. So I did some digging. I'm like, all right, well, how bad is this answer? Like, what are people complaining about? Well, this one is wild to me. So it's a normal rectangular board game box. But there are three cardboard slots that just slide together to create three triangles within the box. They're standing vertically in the box, just separating things into triangles. And there are no triangular components in the game. It is utterly bizarre. I don't know who thought that this was a viable and useful solution. Now, this game is an offering from designer Phil Walker Harding. Now, I know that, you know, designers design games. They don't design boxes. They don't design box inserts. That's the publishers. But I'm going to leave that comment there for my next one.
So I have played Baron Park. It's a solid polyomino-based game, building a theme park dedicated to bears. It's on the lighter side, which is one of the reasons I never picked it up. Probably would have been good to have in the collection for like public play events, but at the time, I wasn't hosting a lot then. Now, I only played a store demo copy and wasn't the one who set it up and taught it, so I didn't actually get to see what the box insert looks like. But I got to say, your description of that also reminds me of the kids talisman game that I'm drawing a complete blank on the full name of, where you had to like build this insert as part of like the cardboard that was in the box. And then it didn't actually work very well for holding the components.
Yeah. That sounds about, the same.
Though there were no weird triangles. You would figure a polyomino game, it'd be at least Tetris shapes or something.
No, it's literally just like strips of cardboard crossed over, laid vertically in the box. Wow. that ends up, you know, it's weird.
Well, next one I've got is Fields of Arl, because I've never seen a two-player only game with so much stuff. This game is ridiculous. This is a prime example of a board game I own that Deanna and I like that doesn't hit the table because of having to organize and sort everything and set it up and put it away. Like, baggies just don't cut it here. Like, we're looking at half an hour of setup of, okay, dump this bag. Okay, that gets laid here, and this tile gets laid here, and this goes in this market. And, oh, do you have your lighthouse? Okay, make sure it's there. Okay, do you have all these? Like, it is over the top, the amount of stuff in this box. Probably some of the most cardboard I've ever seen in a board game. Now, I did pick up an insert for this one, but I messed up. It ends up, there are two printings of this game, and each printing is in a different sized box. And I got the insert for the wrong size. And honestly, you know what? I still haven't played the game since. What I should do is go find a proper fitting insert and put it together and then maybe we'll actually play it a little more often. Now, another thing worth noting, since I did get this game, and I think the box insert I had accounted for it, there is an expansion that makes it no longer a two-player only game, that you can play three players. And there might even be another one that lets you play four. I know there's at least an expansion to let you play three players. So be aware, if you are shopping for box inserts for Fields of Arl, that make sure you have room for the three-player expansion if you plan on picking that up, and double, triple check that box size.
All right, so next up, I picked Terraforming Mars. So this is another big box with everything just floating around in there. And I have two issues with this one. The first is Terraforming Mars is mostly cards. And Mo's already touched on this a bit, but I feel pretty strongly on this. Cards do not belong just in Ziploc bags banging around in a box. It's not good. It doesn't do a good job of keeping the cards in shape. It's not great for the other components either. The second thing is expansions. There are a bunch of expansions for Terraforming Mars. You can fit a bunch of expansion content into the base box, but again, everything's just mashed in there and it's banging about. So a decent insert, one that allows for the expansion content, and as Mo was talking about, allows for you to keep it separate from everything else. That would really help get this game to the table more often and keep stuff from getting damaged.
Terraforming Mars is one of the only thing now is I managed to nestle it so everything fits in the base box without taking extra room. Now I know Stronghold has produced a Terraforming Mars big box, but it's big. So by the time, if you actually threw an insert in there, it wouldn't fit in the box anymore. So that is a consideration of shelf space. But yeah, I have lots of games where my cards are just in baggies to protect them as best I can. And I guess at least the baggies are better than elastics, but they're not great.
I opened up Terraforming Mars this afternoon to look at it and see if it was as bad as I remembered. It does not look happy in there. That's all I'm going to say.
All right. Well, I ended my last one with a comment about a designer. And there was a reason to my badness. And this next entry is yet another game from Phil Walker Harding. And that's Sushi Go Party. Although Sushi Go Original could fall in here too. So there are very few people who can get this boxed up neatly in the intended designed manner. And even if you do, God help you if you don't store it flat. Or if you want to sleeve the card-based party game. While there are certainly worse inserts by far, or completely missing inserts, this isn't one you just want to let anyone try and put away at the end of a group game night. Leave it to the experts. And Sushi Go was as well. It was really interesting. I didn't put any other games of his on the list. We were going through the list of games people complained about. It was strange that there are a number of Phil Walker Harding games on there, because again, we know that publishers design the game boxes. It's not even all the same publisher who he has distributed his games with, and yet a number of his games have fallen onto this list. It's really bizarre.
All right, my last one is a game that I want an insert for. That is the big Marrakesh Classic Edition from Queen Games. Now, well, we've done what we can with baggies. And again, the air dry clay containers, oh, those are so useful at times. I have one container per keshi and there are 12 different keshi colors and they all perfectly fit in there. This game could really use some more organization. Setup is a bear, and it is affecting how often the game gets played. And it's one of the main reasons I haven't brought this out to any public play events, despite being one of the best Seffenfeld games I've ever played. Because I'm worried about losing something from dumping baggies and trying to find something. Whereas if everything was organized in nice containers, wood, I don't know, 3D printed, folded space. Sorry, we were trying not to mention any companies tonight. I just screwed up. Foam core, that's what I meant to say. Foam core or whatever. Some type of insert would be so much better. The other thing is something I alluded to earlier is the expansion thing. So one of the big things Queen Games did with this whole city series of Steffenfeld games is included like all their Queenies, all their little small expansions and promos. And like each of these games in the series has 4 to 10 mini expansions in every box. And sorting these out is a pain. And I would love a better system than what I have right now in Marrakesh is here's all the main game, and here's a big baggie with all the expansion content in one bag, which generally means I never use any expansion content because then I'd have to sort through this bag and figure out what goes with which.
I'm downstairs in our game room this afternoon pulling games off the shelf to check if they have inserts or lack thereof and if they're as bad as I remember. And I'm pulling all these games out, and I noticed something interesting because a bunch of the games that I ended up picking to talk about tonight, like Zolkin and Terraforming Mars, all of these are games that are just a big box with everything banging around in there, and all of our copies have split box corners. So now I'm wondering, is there a correlation between having a box insert and keeping the exterior of the box in good shape? Anyway, my last pick is Terra Mystica, and yes, I noticed a split box corner when I pulled this one off the shelf, and yes, it is just a giant empty box with tons of pieces banging around in there. We have everything in plastic bags, again, which does help, but this game is a pain to get out of the box and set up. It's one of my favorite games, and I end up playing it on Board Game Arena a lot more than I do in real life, and maybe an insert would solve that.
All right, well, the last one on my list is Endangered. Now, this game doesn't really come with an insert at all. It would fall under the just a bunch of things banging around in the box category, except there's this piece of foam. One very sort of custom piece of foam, L-shaped piece of foam, that keeps the board fitting tightly inside the box. And we've kept it because it stops the board from banging around and may actually prevent a little bit of damage to the corners. But baggies are an absolute must for this game, so you can separate out the individual player components. Mm-hmm. But yeah, having a custom insert for this would be far better, and that's before you start adding in all the various expansions mm-hmm. that are published, and then again all of the fan created expansions that exist for this game as well. There's so much for this game. All right, well, let's wrap up our list with a few honorable mentions.
First one I have, and mainly because, like Sean said, we do some research before these episodes, and I was looking up what other people complained about, and it was Anachrony, the original version of the game. Now, this is the second game. I went to that Board Game Geek thread and did the whole Plano thing. And I got to say, in this case, it really helped to get to the table, get the game played. The biggest one, just being a small fishing lure style box that I picked up at Canadian Tire to hold the resources and citizen tokens, just could speed things up because we could pass them between the players. So like someone would go to the mining spot and be like, here you go. Or it was during the setup, or someone's like, I hired one of these people. Instead of having to fish around, it's just you pass the box. Now, usually I'm good with just wooden bowls, right? We love our wooden bowls here, but in this particular game, there were enough different resources and things and tokens that this was better. Now, this is an honorable mention because with the Infinity Box, which came out, which I backed on Kickstarter, this is no longer a problem because this has one of the best game trays inserts that I've ever seen. I should say it's like multiple inserts. It's layers of inserts. And they do the thing I've mentioned now 3 times tonight, which is they not only sort the base game stuff, each of the expansions is its own, like, standalone little package that you can take out and use. And I love that. Though I got to admit, I made the mistake of punching the entire thing. Don't do that. If you pick up the Anachrony Infinity Box, each punch board, like, the expansions are all on their own punch board. Read through the where everything goes first and don't punch everything and mash it all together and start looking for little tiny icons on things to know what expansion they go with. Not a problem now, though, because it's all sorted. So when someone comes over, like, oh, I want to play with this expansion. We're like, okay, here we go. We grab that tray, we add it in.
I have photos of you and Sean sitting at this table trying to sort those pieces out. And the facial expressions and the...
Well, it was just that there was a solution, like we missed it, right?
And that's a fantastic insert. I mean, the upgrade from Anachrony to Infinity Box is just night and day between the individual player boxes and tech stuff. And, you know, just everything about that Infinity Box is so well thought out for playing the game and getting it on the table.
And then the same deal, Eclipse, right? Switching from Eclipse to Eclipse Second Dawn for the galaxy. Eclipse was a bit of a mess to organize, but if you picked up like the alien ship expansions and all the other upgrades and expansions for it, it became a real mess. Now that was all fixed with the Second Dawn, which again, game trays for the win. What's funny about this one, this just happened. So for Father's Day, what I wanted to play was Eclipse Second Dawn, and I brought it over to my mother-in-law's, and we had a big five-player game, and it was great, but it went late because the kids had never played a 4X game, and I kind of threw them in, you know, threw them into the deep end with this one. Well, at the end of the night, we didn't leave till like midnight, so we left it at my mother-in-law's. And we're like, we'll come back the next day and clean it up. And she texted and was like, no, it's all taken care of. Well, we were there on the weekend and I went over Sunday and she's like, oh, know what I loved? I was going to put that game away and there was a set of instructions on how to sort everything. That was so awesome. Every game should have that. And I'm like, I totally agree. So there is something, a caveat to everything we said tonight. If anyone does put out a box insert for any of these games, also include instructions on what goes where.
All right, my turn. Can I talk about Ultimatch here? As that game has the worst box. It doesn't need an insert. It just needs the box tossed out and replaced. Like, it comes in an, like, I think they wanted it to be the standard Uno size box. And then inside, it's a standard deck of card-sized cards. And this weird little trough to keep it in there that slides around all the time. And the rule book and this trough, and there's bad things. Every time you take it in and out, it annoys the heck out of me. I'm just going to take it out and put it in a little plastic box and never find it again on the shelf.
Yeah, I got to say, I'm kind of surprised to have a card game on the list, but she's right. Like, cards slip underneath this weird cardboard thing to make it, I don't know. And like, you assume they expect you to keep the box. Like, unless you put all your card games in a quiver or something.
I don't know. It's interesting because one thing we haven't really touched on here is the number of boxes out there that may hold the game securely, but are three quarters air.
Yeah.
There are a lot of them out there. So it's yeah, fine. It keeps everything from bashing around, but why is the box the size it is? The insert essentially just takes up all the space, the extra space in the box, which is a whole other sort of topic on this front.
Yeah, and to be fair, Deanna and I were talking when we were talking about this episode, and I said that should be a standalone episode. We should talk about shipping air was going to be the name of the episode, where we can talk about games that take up far too much space and the crafter market of reboxing games, which is different than doing box inserts. All right, I got another honorable mention. No one can get this game anymore, so I guess it's not much of a problem. But Battlestar Galactica from Fantasy Flight Games. But this is not to get the game to the table more or to get it cleaned up or to get it sorted. The reason this box insert is needed is space. This game, with all the expansions, is four boxes. Four separate boxes of that standard Fantasy Flight square box. Not the big coffins, but the square boxes. I picked up one insert. One wooden insert. All four boxes are in one box now, all of them, and they're all sorted by expansion. Plus, I get the bonus of, you know, here's the Cylon tray, here's the Colonial Viper tray, and everything else. So this one I had to throw on the list because, my gosh, I have a lot of games, and I'm out of room. So anytime I can make a game take up 25% of the room it used to, that's a good thing for me.
All right, I got one more honorable mention, and that's Zensu. It is, of course, perfect and does not require an insert, but I still think a drawstring bag would be a good upgrade here. And if you pair it with the cloth version of the playmat, you have an ideal travel game.
Well, there you go. So we have 15 games plus a few honorable mentions that we think basically need a box insert or a box insert upgrade, something to help with the setup and takedown to get the game to the table more often.
So now let's take a moment to look at what our lobby has been talking about. I've seen a bunch of games fly by. I want to hear what they think could use organization, what they could use to get the games to the table more.
So Red Meeple Ryan, who asked this question, starts off with the first worst insert I've encountered and have yet to place is the Village Big Box.
Okay, Village, I remember I have the base game. I didn't get the expansions or the big box. But we will note that one in the show notes. We should play Village again. Village is a good game.
Trasher Rama's mentioning that he lives in his Gloomhaven box. and when Frosthaven came out, he used it as a home expansion.
Nice. You know, put the shed out back with Jaws of the Lion, you know? That box is big. It's really big. So I think Nova Aetis Renaissance, which is behind me, is actually larger in some possible unfathomable
way. But not
way.
As heavy.
No, it's not as heavy. I will say that. There's your disadvantage to box inserts. Wooden box inserts have weight.
Conquest of Planet Earth insert is okay, but just barely sufficient for the expansion with no sleeved card support in the wells.
Yeah, sleeve card support, I realize, is a big thing. It's not something that affects me all that often. As I said, I tend to play unprotected, but
I did see in my research a lot of people. It's like, hey, you know, this is a problem with sleeved, or hey, we have to redo it this way if we're going to use it sleeved, and blah, 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 a lot of that. Ryan saying Guild Academies should have come with a proper insert.
Yeah, we're going to mention that one as we review Guild Academies later tonight. We didn't put it on the main list. I didn't think it was egregious, but yes, I agree.
And on the good side, on a positive note, it's nice to say good things as well. Lords of Waterdeep for one of the best cardboard inserts.
It wasn't cardboard. It was plastic vacuum foamed, and it did some really cool stuff. It was one of the first inserts I ever saw that had it where, like, there were bumps under the tokens. So if you pushed on them, they flipped up so you could pick them up. The problem was they put in an expansion, and as soon as they put out the expansion, that you couldn't keep them both in the same box. So that is one I actually did purchase, a wooden box insert that holds both the base game and the expansion. So yes, I did like the Lords of Waterdeep one when all I owned was Lords of Waterdeep. The other problem was, though, that was not one designed to hold the game up or down.
So apparently the one Ryan had was a cardboard insert. Interesting.
Okay. Yeah, mine was plastic. Maybe a different printing. They switched it to cardboard.
All right, Victor mentions Heroes of Normandy. Had to come up with his own solution for all the boards and unit pieces. That game, with many expansions, is just an explosion of cardboard.
I like that description. That is a game I've always wanted to try, and there's other versions of it. I personally want to play the Heroes of Black Reach version, which is the Warhammer 40K version of Normandy. It's Heroes of Black Reach. I am really curious about the game. It's from Yellow. It looks neat. It's kind of looks like XCOM, but in board game form.
That's what we should have named the episode, an explosion of cardboard.
It's not a bad name.
Ryan mentioning Dungeon Lords badly needs a good insert, and he has tried and failed three times to successfully create his own.
What I can't remember is I ended up buying the, like, festival season, like the big box version of that. I can't, it was a happy anniversary. I think it's Dungeon Lords Happy Anniversary Edition. And I can't remember if I think it had an insert in it. So I'd have to look at mine.
See, look at the chat room, Mo.
Yeah, yeah, Dungeon Lord's 5th anniversary had an over-designed... Yeah, see, I thought so. Though over-design might be a bit much. I do remember it had these little game trays things, like these little pop-out things that came off that looked cooler than they were. Like, they're hard to open and close, and every time people grab them, they go to open them, and then I get, you know, confetti. Goblins all over the room.
It's yes. Anniversary! Confetti! Yes.
Happy exactly. Anniversary! Yeah. Goblins everywhere! Oh, the meat just flew across the room.
Ryan here again. Jet Set needs an insert badly, but also needs a bigger box to fit it with expansion content.
So an interesting one about that, and I still think this is one of the smartest things I saw Bonacor and Stronghold Games do, is Core Worlds, which at one time was my favorite deck builder. Might still be, I just don't play it often enough. Core Worlds was a standalone game, and you got it, and it was in like a smaller box. It didn't have a lot of air, which was impressive. Well, then they put out the first expansion. Well, the first expansion was a huge box that had a ton of air in it. But the whole point was you were supposed to port over the original game into the box. Now it fit the expansion. And I thought that was brilliant. I'm like, next expansion, put it on an even bigger box that holds all three of them. But then fans like flipped out. They're like, I don't want to put the base game in the expansion box. I'm like, why is the expansion box lesser than the base game box? It still says Core Worlds. Like, I found it baffling. And I'm wondering if that's the reason why you don't see it more.
By that line of thought, it's better off to have the core game be in a bigger box than shipping air.
Yes.
So that you have room for potential expansions if you want them.
Yes.
That's what people think.
Yes. That is the argument I saw.
This is my game. I want to keep the base game in the base game, and everything should go into that box, which honestly makes no sense to me.
Yeah, I don't understand it, but fair enough. To each their own, if that's how you prefer things. I don't understand it. Like, I don't know. I'll admit, I find reboxing weird. Like those people that take all their games and put them into photo cases. I'm like, I love the concept of that, but I hate doing it because I want my hoard. I want to look at all my games and see the names and be able to find them.
I'm super curious about the math on the shipping and the environmental impact and which way is actually better as far as the shipping.
Well, aspect. I would shipping have to
giant boxes of expansion, but only to the people that actually bother to want the expansion, right? And I'm like, I'm curious about that now.
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking it's got to be more environmentally friendly or better the other way, because not everyone's going to buy the expansion. This way, only the people that bought the expansion get the extra air in the bigger box.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, sorry. Divergent. Squirrel.
Fair enough. Let's see. We've got the Terraforming Mars big box. Darkling Blight ended up getting third-party laser-cut MDF inserts for Terraforming Mars to fit the base game and expansions in, but they still have one of the expansion boxes for the boards. So there's a lot of stuff once you get all the expansions of Terraforming Mars, which is, I think, where part of the problem comes in.
The problem with Terraforming Mars, too, is they're still putting out more. So if you go out and buy a box insert today, Prelude 2 is coming soon, right? Or is that? That might even be out by now.
Let's see. We got Ryan saying Merchants and Marauders needs an insert badly.
Not one I played, but I know our local heavy gamer Charles loves that game.
And Ryan's mentioning that Eagle Griffin and some other publishers have been experimenting with just selling expansions as shrink wrapped.
I've seen a few.
Which that's, you know, if you can do it, again, anything you can do to minimize the carbon footprint of this this hobby we have. Plus,
if it fits in the base game, you don't need another box. Like, not even just carbon footprint. Just, I don't need another box. I'm going to end up recycling it anyway.